It's now considered a ghost town, but back in the late 1800s, Sandon was a prosperous city in the province's West Kootenays. Veronica Cooper has the story.
So these are some of the records that we have in our collection.
Sandon, BC is located in the West Kootenays in a steep, narrow valley divided by a creek.
Silver was first discovered there in 1891, and the town was soon flooded with miners. It was a very high quality grade of silver, so it was very profitable. It was located really close to the surface, so it was very cheap to extract as well. Within a few years, the town was bustling. It incorporated in 1898, and at its peak had about 5,000 people living there. It was a big town. It had an opera house, two different rail lines, plenty of shops.
The town also had a reputation.
An 1897 police report states the town is at times almost flooded with disorderly characters. The most common crimes were gambling, drunk and disorderly conduct, and frequenting houses of ill fame.
But a major fire changed everything.
Unfortunately, on May 4th, 1900, there was a really big fire. No one was injured, but it destroyed most of the downtown core. These are some of the town council minutes from after the fire. Here you can see the city council is thanking the work of the volunteer fire department for saving what they could of the town.
Residents rebuilt the downtown as quickly as they could, but the buildings were not as grand as they were before the flames, and then more bad luck.
After the fire, the price of silver began to decline, so that made it less profitable, and some people ran into financial difficulties.
In 1913, Sandon went into receivership.
And this one is records from when the town went into receivership. They were selling off some of the land and assets, and then it was disincorporated in 1920. When World War II arrived, there were only about 20 people living there still, but it was chosen for a site for Japanese-Canadian internment.
953 Japanese-Canadians were forcibly removed from the coast and housed there.
The town was pretty much abandoned at that time, so they were forced to rebuild and renovate the structures so they had somewhere to live. They were really, really isolated. The only way to get there was a train that showed up once a week, and that's how they got all their supplies.
After the war, Mother Nature once again brought the few remaining residents more devastation.
In 1946, there was a really big snowfall that destroyed a lot of the buildings. And then in 1955, a huge flood happened and destroyed pretty much all of the remaining structures.
Today, Sandon has just a few full-time residents and a museum seasonally open to the public.
This Week in History, brought to you by the Royal BC Museum, bringing British Columbia's stories together.